In our previous Dhamma talk, we had explained about Dukkha Sikya. Today, I would like to explain Samudaya Sikya again. In the same way, the Buddha taught Samudaya Sikya, the origin of suffering in three ways. This is the noble truth of the origin of suffering. Thus, Bhikkhus, in regards to Dhamma's unheard before, there arose in me vision, there arose in me insight, there arose in me understanding, there arose in me wisdom, there arose in me light.
在上次的开示当中，禅师解释《转法轮经》，讲到苦地的经文。今天继续解释关于极地的经文。接着佛陀同样以三种方式来教导极地，极地也就是苦的因。经文说，再者诸比丘，当我思维着此是苦集圣地时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
Although our Buddha had fulfilled many perfections by sacrificing his life for more than 4 incalculable 100,000 aeons, out of great compassion, he still had a slight attachment to the Buddha's life. It was because he knew that when he became a Buddha, he could help beings to escape from the round of rebirths.
由于大悲心的缘故，我们的菩萨以四阿僧祇劫与十万大劫以上的时间，不惜生命地积聚了无量的波罗蜜。尽管如此，他对佛陀的生命仍然有轻微的执着，因为他知道成佛后将能帮助众生解脱生死轮回。
According to the Abhidhamma commentary, Atta Salini, the strong and powerful force on Dhamma's before Middha Jhana were the karmic force of our bodhisattvas resulting aggregates. Perceiving the Buddha as a Buddha, but not materiality and mentality, was ignorance. Depending on the ignorance, he wished to become a Buddha. This was craving.He clung to that Buddha's life, this was clinging. The strong and powerful force on Dhamma's before Middha Jhana were Sankhara's volitional formations. The force of these volitional formations was called Kamma. Altogether, there were 5 past causes: ignorance, avijja, craving, tanha, clinging, upadana, volitional formations, Sankhara, and Kamma.The Buddha knew that these 5 past causes were his origin of suffering, Samudaya Sikya. This is Sikya Jnana.
根据阿毗达摩藏当中法句论的注释殊胜译注，造成我们的菩萨最后这一世果报五蕴的业力，乃是他前一世临死时成熟的慈心观善业力，那是尚未达到慈心禅那之前强而有力的善法。那时他发愿要成佛，将佛陀认定为佛陀，也就是认为有佛陀的实体存在是无明。由于那无明，他发愿成为佛陀，就是爱。他执着佛陀的生命是取，慈心强而有力的慈心观善业是行，那些行的业力是业。如此的无明爱取行业，是过去的五种因。佛陀了知这五项过去因是极地，也就是这一生苦的原因。这是地智。
If you practice Vipassana, you must also try to know that this is Samudaya Siddha. Samudaya Siddha is the origin of Dukkha Siddha. Especially in this case, you must try to understand the origination, the relationship between cause and effect. When you are inside knowledge, without knowing the dependent origination, you cannot realize Nibbana, because this is the second noble truth.
在你修行观禅时，你也必须了知苦的原因，特别是指必须了知缘起法，以观智照见因果关系。如果不了知缘起法，就不能证悟涅槃，因为极地是四圣地中的一项。
Again, the Buddha continues, this noble truth of the origin of suffering is to be abandoned. Thus, Bhikkhus, in regards to Dhamma's unheard purport, there arose in me vision, there arose in me insight, there arose in me understanding, there arose in me wisdom, there arose in me light.
佛陀继续开示说，诸比丘，当我思维着此苦集圣地应当被断除时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
The origin of suffering is ignorance, avidya, craving, tanha, and clinging upadana. You must destroy them with your insight knowledge and path knowledge. If you can completely destroy or abandon these defilements without remainder, then your karmic force cannot produce any result. That coming force can produce a result only dependent on avijjatana and upadana. Without avijjatana and upadana, the coming force cannot produce any result. So, that origin of dukkha is to be abandoned means you must destroy these defilements completely without remainder with your insight knowledge and path knowledge. This is Kaisha Jnana, which means the knowledge of what has to be done. What do you have to be done? You have to abandon, or according to explanation of commentary, you have to kill the defilements. Remainderless cessation of defilements is necessary in this case.
无明爱取是苦的原因，必须以观智和道智来灭除它们。如果能完全灭除这些烦恼，那么你的一切未成熟业力就不能产生任何果报。业力只有在无明爱取的帮助下才能结成果报，若没有无明爱取的帮助，业力就无法结成果报。因此经文中所说此苦集圣地应当被断除，这句话是指应当以观智和道智来完全灭除烦恼，这是坐智。坐智意思就是了知应当做之事的智慧。你应当做什么呢？你应当灭除烦恼。根据注释的解释，你应当杀死烦恼，这是指应当将烦恼灭尽无余。
The Buddha continues, this noble truth of origin of suffering has been abandoned. Thus, because in regards to Dhamma's unheard people, there arose in me vision, there arose in me insight, there arose in me understanding, there arose in me wisdom, there arose in me light.
佛陀继续开示说，诸比丘，当我思维着此苦集圣地已经被断除时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
This is Kadanyana. Kadanyana means the knowledge of what has been done. What had he done? The Buddha had abandoned or killed the defilements. So in Smuriya Sijja, there are also three types of knowledge. Sijja Jnana, Pichya Jnana, and Kadanyana. If you are practicing Vipassana, you must understand that this is Smuriya Sijja. This is Sijja Jnana here. You must try to know that this Smuriya Sijja has to be abandoned or to be killed. This is Kichya Jnana. Then if you realize Nibbana, your birth knowledge will step by step completely destroy these defilements with the remainder, especially the Tanha, Smuriya Sijja. At that time, you will understand that you have abandoned or killed the Smuriya Sijja Dhamma, the things that are the origin of suffering. That is Kata Jnana.
这是已作智，已作智意思是了知已经完成之事的智慧。佛陀已经完成了什么呢？佛陀已经灭除了，或者说杀死了烦恼。因此在极地中有地智、坐智及已作智这三种智慧。在修行观禅时，你必须了知极地，这是地智，你必须明了此苦因是应当被灭除或杀死的，这是坐智。当你证悟涅槃时，你的道智会逐步地彻底灭除烦恼，尤其是爱欲，那时你就会明了自己已经灭除或杀死了极地法，这是已作地。
In the same way, the Buddha taught Nirodha Sijja in three ways. Please listen. This is the noble truth of the cessation of suffering. Thus, bhikkhus in Ragadu Dhammas are hard people. They arose in me vision, they arose in me insight, they arose in me understanding, they arose in me wisdom, they arose in me light. This is Sijja Jnana, which means the Buddha knows that this is Nirodha Sijja, the cessation of suffering. How did he cease suffering? When he was practicing Vipassana, his inside knowledge realized all Dukkha Sijja Dhammas. That means the five aggregates subject to clinging. And all Smuriya Sijja Dhammas, that means the 12 fetters of dependent origination, as Anicca, Dukkha, and another. He practiced Vipassana in this way. At the end of his Vipassana, he realized Nibbana. When he realized Nibbana, he saw the remainderless cessation of the five aggregates subject to clinging and 12 fetters of dependent origination. How? His birth knowledge, which took Nibbana as object, destroying all defilements stage by stage. Because of the remainderless cessation of defilements, his coming post could not produce any result after his pre-Nibbana. Because of the remainderless cessation of five causes, five clinging aggregates completely ceased without remainder. He saw two types of remainderless cessation in this way.
同样的，佛陀以三种方式教导灭谛如下。经文说，再者，诸比丘，当我思维着此是灭圣谛时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。这是谛智，意思就是佛陀了知此是灭谛，灭谛就是苦的灭尽。佛陀是如何灭苦的呢？当他修行观禅时，他的观智了知所有的苦谛法与极谛法为无常、苦、无我。如此修行观禅达到终点时，他证悟了涅槃。证悟涅槃时， 他见到五取蕴与十二缘起之的灭尽无余。如何照见呢？他那取涅槃为目标的道智，逐步地灭除所有的烦恼。由于烦恼灭尽无余，因此在薄涅槃后，业力无法产生任何果报。因为五种因灭尽无余，所以五取蕴灭尽无余。他如此地见到这两种灭尽无余。
The Buddha continues, this noble truth of the cessation of suffering is to be realized. Thus, bhikkhus and ragadu dhammas are hard people. They arose in me vision, they arose in me insight, they arose in me understanding, they arose in me wisdom, they arose in me light.
佛陀接着开示说，诸比丘，当我思维着此灭圣地应当被证悟时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
This is Kṛṣṇa Jñāna, which means the knowledge of what must be done. In this case, when you are practicing vipassana, you must try to realize nibbana.
这是坐智，也就是了知应当坐之事的智慧。在你修行观禅时，应当努力于证悟涅槃，涅槃就是灭谛。
Again, the Buddha continues to teach Kṛṣṇa-jñāna. This noble truth of the cessation of suffering has been realized. Large bhikkhus and ragadu dhammas are hard people. They arose in me vision, they arose in me insight, they arose in me understanding.They arose in me wisdom, they arose in me light.
佛陀继续开示说，诸比丘，当我思维着此灭圣地已经被证悟时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起 真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
This is Kṛṣṇa-jñāna, which means the knowledge of what has been done. What had he done? He had realized Nibbana. He knew that he had realized Nibbana. When you practice Vipassana and realize Nibbana, you will also know that you have realized Nibbana.
这是已作智，意思就是了知已作之事的智慧。佛陀已经做了什么事呢？他已经证悟了涅槃，他了知自己已经证悟涅槃。当你修行观禅到证悟涅槃时，也会了知自己已经证悟涅槃。
Then the Buddha continues to explain Magga Sijja in three ways. This is the noble truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering.Thus, bhikkhus and ragadu dhammas are hard people. They arose in me vision, they arose in me insight, they arose in me understanding, they arose in me wisdom, they arose in me light.
然后佛陀以三种方式解释道谛如下。再者，诸比丘，当我思维着此是导致苦灭的道圣谛时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
So when the Buddha got enlightened, he knew that the Noble Eightfold Path is the brightest or the path leading to the cessation of suffering. In the same way, if you are trying Vipassana,You should also try to know that the Noble Eightfold Path is the path of brightness leading to the cessation of suffering. This is Sijja Jnana.
因此，当佛陀证悟时， 他了知八圣道分是导致苦灭的修行方法，或者说道路。同样的，在你修行观禅时，也应当努力了知八圣道分是导致苦灭的修行方法或道路，这是谛字。
The Buddha continues to teach Kaccha Jnana. This noble truth of the path leading to the cessation of suffering is to be developed. Thus Vikus and Raga to Dhammas are hard people. They arose in me patience, they arose in me insight, they arose in me understanding, they arose in me wisdom, they arose in me light.
接着佛陀开示坐智，诸比丘，当我思维着此导致苦灭的道圣地应当被修行时，这是前所未闻之法，我的心中升起彻见，升起真知，升起智慧，升起明智，升起光明。
In the same way, if you are practicing vipassana, you must try to know the Noble Eightfold Path. This is the path leading to the cessation of suffering. There are altogether eight fetters. Right view, right thinking, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right mindfulness, right effort, right mindfulness, right concentration.I would like to explain a little bit more. When you are practicing vipassana, first you must understand the five aggregates subject to clinging. Secondly, you must try to know the origin of suffering, especially the factors of dependent origination. These dukkha sijja dhammas and smuriya sijja dhammas are called sankhara dhammas, formations. They are impermanent by nature, so they are anicca.They are always oppressed by rising and passing away, so they are dukkha. There is no stable self in them, so they are anatta. When you are practicing in this way, your practice is called vipassana. At that time, penetrating the impermanent nature, unpleasant nature, or non-self nature of these sankhara dhammas is samadhi, right view. Obligation of the mind to theseNatures of the Sankhara Dhammas is Samasankappa, right thinking. The effort to penetrate these natures of the Sankhara Dhammas is Samavayama, right effort. Mindfulness on these natures of Sankhara Dhammas is Samasati, right mindfulness. Concentration on these natures of the Sankhara Dhammas is Samadhi, right concentration.So all together, there are five fetters.
修行观禅时，你必须了知八圣道分，这是导致苦灭之道。八圣道分包括八相，也就是正见、正思维、正语、正业、正命、正精进、正念以及正定。禅师要稍加解释。修行观禅时，首先你必须了知五取蕴，五取蕴就是苦谛。其次必须了知苦的因，也就是极谛，尤其是指缘起法。这些苦谛法与极谛法称为行法，它们升起之后就立刻坏灭，因此它们是无常的。他们受到不断生灭的逼迫，因此是苦的。在他们之中没有稳定的自我存在，因此是无我的。如此修行称为观禅。那时透视这些行法无常、苦、无我三相的是正见，将心投入行法三相的是正思维。为了透视行法三相而付出的努力是正精进，对行法三相铭记不忘是正念，专注于行法三相是正定， 如此总共是五相圣道分。
When you reach Vinganyana stage, you must discern both Jnana and Jnana as Anicca, Dukkha or Anatta. Jnana, literally, what is to be known, means here five aggregates or Sankhara Dhammas. Jnana means inside knowledge. At that time, the inside knowledge arises as a thought process. In this thought process, there are one mind or embodying consciousness and seven impulsions, jhanas. In the mind or embodying consciousness moment, there are 12 mental formations. In each impulsion thought moment, there are usually 34 mental formations. Among these mental formations, the aforementioned five fetters of the Noble Eightfold Path are predominant. You must also see this inside knowledge as anicca or dukkha or anatta. At that time, you can easily understand these five predominant fetters. They are the path leading to the cessation of suffering, because at that time you have already understood that because of the remainderless cessation of causes, five clinging aggregates will also cease completely with the remainder. When you are inside knowledge, Uriyabhya, Jnana.
修行达到坏灭随观智时，你必须观照所知与能知都是无常、苦、无我。所知是指无取运或者行法，能知是指观智。观智以心路过程的形态升起，在此心路过程中有一个一门转向心以及七个塑形心。在一门转向心刹那中有十二个明法，而在每一个塑形心刹那中通常有三十四个明法。在这三十四个明法当中，上面提到的五相圣道分是最显著的明法。你必须观照此能知的观智也是无常、苦、无我，那时你就能轻易地照见这五相圣道分，它们就是导致苦灭之道。因为那时你已经透过生灭随观智清楚地了知，由于五种因灭尽无余，所以五蕴也会灭尽无余。
In the Noble Eightfold Path, there are eight fetters. Now I have explained only five fetters. You should not misunderstand. When you are practicing Vipassana, you have already observed Patimokkha monastic rules, 10, 9, 8, or 5 precepts. Thus, Samavaja, right speech, Samagamanda, right action, and Samajiva, right livelihood are already present. They also arise as a cognitive thought process together with concomitant mental formations. You must also contemplate them as anicca, dukkha or anatta. So all together they are eight fetters of the Noble Eightfold Path.